Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to walk you through the process to do a compression test on our Yamaha T60 engine. Now, it's really simple to do. All we're going to need is a compression tester, and that's really about it. But this is such a pivotal way to check out the health of an engine. So if you're ready, let's dive into it. Okay, guys, the one I've chosen is a compression tester made by Motion Pro, but no matter which brand you go with, you're going to use them in the same way. All right, guys, step number one, if you can, is going to start up your motor and let it warm up a bit. What we're looking for from Yamaha is a minimum compression of 122 pounds. Now, ours is going to be cold, so it may be a little bit less than that 122. I'm hoping not. But what we're really looking for is consistency across the board. You do not want to see more than a 5 to 10% deviation going from cylinder to cylinder. Now, step number one, we want to open up the throttle bodies at least partially. That way it doesn't have to fight to pull air past the plates. Now, step number one, let's get the throttle plates held open at least partially. That right there should do it. Next, we want to remove all four of our spark plugs. Now, I'm working on a carbureted model here, so I'm not having to worry about fuel. But if yours is fuel injected, you need to disable the fuel pump to where it doesn't drown the cylinders. So that might mean you need to pull a fuse or disconnecting a relay, depending on your model. Now, Motion Pro has three different hose attachments, and that's going to hit the majority of the different spark plug sizes that you're going to run into. We've got our throttle plates at least partially held open. We'll start up top with number one. The way I do this is I turn it over several times until the needle stabilizes at whatever maximum pressure it's going to come up to. So we are at 210, 220. Drop down to number two. All right, let's see what number two can do. Right at 210. Number three. Now, last but not least, number four. This one's a little bit tricky to get to. There she goes. And away we go. An aggressive one there, 10, 20, 30. All right. Are they within the 10%? Yes, barely. But considering we're doing this on a cold engine, I think she's fine. Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap this one up. I think she's ready to head on to the next boat. Well, listen, if you need any parts or tools for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments about this video, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.